Today we will do mooring lines. Now when the ship is berthed and we have very good breast lines and spring lines. Let's say four breast lines forward, four aft, and four springs forward, four springs aft. Now, do we need head ropes and do we need stern ropes? Actually, no, because if you have very good four breast lines with good lead, that will hold forward part of the ship alongside. Aft breast lines will hold the aft part of the ship alongside. And the aft springs will prevent the ship to go back, and the forward springs will prevent the ship to go forward. So you don't need headlines, stern lines. So why do we use headlines and stern lines? We use because these breast lines normally do not give a good lead. For example, if this is your ship and this is the wharf, we need long breast lines like this. But normally these lines are very short because this part of the wharf is used for walkway for the shore crane and trucks and cars. So we get a breast line which is very short and very close to the ship like this. This breast line doesn't give a good lead because, as you can see, it is pulling the ship in this direction, and we want a more horizontal pull. This is more of a vertical pull. It is just pulling the ship downwards. Now suppose this force is 2 tons, I can make a line parallel to this, and this force can be split into one horizontal component, one vertical component. So this is 2 tons, I can split it into horizontal component and one vertical component. And roughly the horizontal pull we are getting is about 1 if this angle is 45 degrees, and vertical pull is also 1. And vertical pull is not helping us, it is just pulling the ship down. Only we are getting this help from the horizontal pull of 1 ton. But if you have a breast line like this, as you can see, now this can also be split into horizontal component and a vertical. So if I make a line parallel to this and complete the rectangle, if this is 2 tons, I will get about 1.5 horizontal pull and maybe just 0.5 vertical. So we normally don't get breast lines like this. We get it like this, which is not helping the ship much, and therefore we use head ropes. And most of these head ropes, as you can see, it is pulling the ship in this direction. So if I split this force into two components, one like this and one like this, complete the rectangle. So if this is 2 tons, I will get 1 ton in this direction, which is a head rope, and I will get 1 ton in this direction, roughly, which is a breast rope. So this rope is partly a breast rope and partly a head rope. That's why we use head ropes and stern ropes. Now, in mooring lines, one thing we have to remember is, as you can see here, this that long lines are better than short. Why? Because long lines become more or less more horizontal, and we need a horizontal pull because ship moves horizontally. So that is one reason that we need a horizontal pull instead of vertical. And the other reason is it gives you more elasticity, so chances of breaking is less chance of breaking. For example, if I have a rubber band which is 1 centimeter long, and if I stretch it to 2 centimeters, then it breaks. Now, if I have another rubber band which is 2 centimeters long, So how much can I stretch it before it breaks? 4 centimeters. So mooring lines are also like rubber bands. They are stretchable. So if I have a short mooring line, it will break faster than a long mooring line. For example, if I have a breaststroke like this, or let's see a headline, short headline, and this is a long headline. Now, if the ship is going up due to discharging cargo or due to high tide, we have to slack these lines little every few hours. Suppose you forget to slack it, then which of the mooring lines, headlines, both are headlines, which will break first? The short one. So that is the reason long lines are better than short. They give more horizontal pull. As you can see, this is giving a more horizontal pull. This is giving horizontal as well as vertical. This is giving more horizontal, very little vertical, as you can see. And less chances of breaking.